Okay, still on our series on groups, we're talking about algebraic systems and structures. We're talking about groups, we discussed abelian groups. What I want to do now is actually break it down. I actually want to talk about examples of groups. So really, you know, what are these elements, what are these groups? So what I want to discuss today are examples of groups. So the first example, I want to do my explanation this way. Let's consider an equilateral triangle. Let's see. Now, I can decide to just leave the triangle the way it is. The way it is here, identity. We'll call that the identity. Can call that the identity E. So I can decide to just leave the triangle the way it is. This will be A, this is B, and this is C. I can decide to rotate the triangle 120 degrees, just kind of turn the triangle 120 degrees clockwise. You see, I'm going to be having something of this nature. I'm going to be having A here, I'm going to be having C here, I'm going to be having B here. So I can call this rotation, I can call it a row one. I can call that row one. Now I can see rotate the 120 degrees. I'm sorry, this is happening. See, I can rotate it twice. Rotate it twice. So I'm going to be having A here. I'm going to be having B and C here. So I can call this rotation row 2. I can call that rotation row 2. Here I can rotate this. I'll flip this time. Flip. So I can put my hands here and actually flip this triangle this way. I flip this way. So I can call this reflection. I can call it reflection. But we both know that it's actually a flip. Okay, so I have a reflection here, I have another reflection here, I have another reflection here. So this one, if I flip it this way, this thing will remain constant, but I have B and A interchange. So I'm going to call this mu one. So here I'm going to hold this part and flip this. So I'm going to be having my A still here, but I'm going to have B here and C here. Flip. So here I'm going to hold my B. So I'm going to hold my B and flip this. And at the end of the day, you see we're going to be having B here, and I'm going to be having C and A here. Now you see that in this, we call this actually permutation of an equilateral triangle, arrangement of an equilateral triangle. And in this equilateral triangle, we have three vertices, one, two, three vertices that we can arrange in six, three vertices, three sides, that we can arrange in six different ways. Remember permutation, that we have three sides and three vertices, and 3 factorial is simply 3 times 2 times 1, which is the same thing as 6 ways or 6 permutations. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 symmetries. So you're going to see a picture right now. Check out that picture, you're going to have a table of this. So that you can pause and take a good look at the table. So you have symmetry, arrangement of 3 sides, 3 angles. Now what am I going to bring up from here? These symmetries actually form a group. So we have a group here, which I'm going to call X, that contains the elements. And what are the elements? The identity element. This is mu 2 and this is mu 3. So we have identity element, we have row 1, we have row 2, we have mu 1, we have mu 2 and mu 3. So you can see that this is the set of these six rotations, or six symmetries, let me use the word symmetries. And if this that you can see that we have to, we can compose, we can actually rotate this and now flip. So we can rotate this and flip, we can flip and rotate, we can do all those compositions. So that becomes a binary operation here. It becomes a binary operation. So when I have this set and this binary operation, the binary operation has to do with the flipping and rotation and turning, that this now forms a group. It forms a group. Good news. Now, this can be arranged in terms of permutation. You can see that originally you have A, B, and C, and what we are going to be having here is that you have kept C constant, and you flipped A to B and B to C. So this is actually what I call mu 1. I'm sorry, I made a mistake here. This is A. So this mu 2 can be this. Mu 2, you see that we kept A constant. So A is constant, B, C. This is flipped to C, and this is to B. So we can actually compose it mathematically, not practically. What happens if I do this reflection and this particular reflection? What happens? Mathematically, we can do that. All we need to do is mu 1, which is an element in this group, compose with mu 2, which is an element in this group. This is how we do it mathematically. So we have A, B, and C, and we have B, A, C, and here composed with mu 2 is A, B, C, and this is A, C, B. So what we want to compose is this, how we do it. Watch it, how we do it. You see, A maps to A here. A maps to A here, and A maps to B here. You see that? B maps to C here, and C maps to C. B maps to C, you can see that, but C here maps to C. So that will give us C, and I'm sorry, that will give us B maps to C and C maps to C. This is going to be C. And at the end of the day, you see C maps to B here and B maps to A. That means C will map to A at the end of the day. Now, do we have this anywhere? Yes, we have this somewhere. We have this. And this is actually by our composition. This is actually the first. So this is actually row 1. This is actually row 1, so this gives you row 1. Remember that row 1 was actually A, B, C, now giving us C, C, B, and A. So you see that A maps to B, B maps to C, and C maps to A. So this is actually row 1. So you see that at the end of the day, if I do this reflection and now do this particular reflection again, I'm going to arrive at another element entirely. But you see that if we have mu 2 composition mu 1, composition mu 1, that is going to be A, B, C, A, C, B, composition A, B, C, and B, A, C. Now let's do that mapping again. Let's do that mapping again. A maps to B here, and B maps to C, so A maps to C. B maps to A, B maps to A, and A maps to A, and you see C maps to C here, while C maps to B here. You see that this element, whatsoever element here, but I suspect it should be row 2. Can you see what is happening? That mu 1, mu 2, composition mu 2 gave us this, and mu 2, composition mu 1 is giving us a different element. What does that say? We have a non-abelian group. So this is an example of a non-abelian group, because you can see that it is not commutative. Mu 1, mu 2 is not the same thing as mu 2, mu 1. So this is a good example of a non-abelian group, a group generally. I'm going to give you another group in the next.